Hallo?
Die Kamera, du machst nur den Kameraleuten Stress.
Hi. Welcome to the Debian Science Buff. Please welcome Andrea Style. Enjoy.
Ja. Oh, mein Schutzswitch auf meinen Screensaver. Ja, okay. Hello, welcome everybody. Welcome the few people. Well, the Debian Science Buff is every year. And I try to give some kind of statistics, who is in the team, what we are doing, but I'm afraid I need to stretch a little bit wider, because see only one person who's a team member. Well, what is Debian Science? Debian Science is a Debian Pure Blend. Debian Pure Blends are subsets of Debian. Pure means pure subset, so nothing is outside, everything is inside, which is covering a certain topic. On the DebConf is the maintainer of Debian Astro, or the founder of Debian Astro. This is a team which is covering astronomy. Debian Med, which I founded in 2002, is covering biology, life sciences, medicine. And we have Debian Games. There was one talk today, which is covering games. And we had Freedom Box today, a talk. It is also a pure blend, not a scientific blend, but it is doing a communication server with only software which is packaged for Debian, which is really cool. I really like it because it's not only the scientific stuff or game stuff. It has real applications. This was for me very good because I've seen a real application of what we are doing. So the history was blends is a strange word. We are blending, we are putting together the best things, like in the coffee, the best things of Debian for a certain purpose. And in science is more or less an umbrella of blend because we have a lot of science. I would love if people would say, oh, let's put Debian mathematics, Debian physics, Debian, whatever science we covered as a separate blend, because the idea of a blend to assemble all experts of one field in one team. And the Debian science team is in principle too large. It covers a lot of people with very different interests, which does not have the good effect to join in very small topics and do the same things. But anyway, it worked as an umbrella, and other science, other blends like Debian Astro were growing out of this umbrella. So, okay, who's in the Debian Science team? These graphs are from the team statistics, which was done in some Google Summer of Code project, which I was introducing in my last session here. Shows who is uploading packages which are maintained by the Debian Science team. I'm not really proud that I'm here the most active uploader. I would love if way more other people would to be more active, but it shows that the team is growing since several years, and there are people, active people coming into the team and doing interesting work. My role is rather doing QA work. I'm not really introducing so much into Debian science. If I see there is a science package with a release critical bug, I try to fix it and upload. This is about the people who are discussing about Debian science. This is natural that I'm doing a lot of discussing because I was one of the founders of this list, and I'm trying to find people who work together and explain what's the sense of the science team, so that I'm discussing here more than others is somehow natural. This is a developer mailing list which has more or less a technical background. There you get some bug reports to this list. Also there are non-members of the team. These are people who are doing a lot of QA work and reporting bugs to this list. That's why are there other people than only team members. We have people who are very busy to hunt bugs in Debian Science. So Anton Gladke is very active. Sylvester Ledru unfortunately left the team because he had some other things to do. Ole Streicher is also here on the campus. I was hoping he would show up here. This is a Debian Astro maintainer. And we have people who are committing to the Git of the packages. This is also a different image here. We have Mo Zhou. I hope I'm speaking this correctly, the Chinese name. This was a Google Summer of Code student who became extremely active, extremely helpful, doing a lot of very good stuff from the machine learning field. And so it is quite a wide spectrum of people who are assembled in the Debian Science team. So what's my definition of a team is, if I'm waking up in the morning and see that somebody else solved my problem from yesterday, this is what I really experienced more in the Debian Mail team, but in other teams which are close, because I had a problem to compile a package. And I send it to the mailing list on Sunday night at 1 o'clock, and I was opening my laptop at 8 o'clock, and somebody said, oh, it's solved, I upload it for you. This is a team, and really want that people understand themselves in the way that that the contributions to the team are very important, and not only your own packages. And I try to express this in another technical graphic representation. I counted the commits of the team members for the packages. And we have more than 350 packages which have only commits from one person. This is not so good. We would love to have commits for one package by 2, 3, or 4 persons. So ideally, this graph would like be like this. You know, only a few packages touched by only one person, but most packages touched by more persons. We have teams which this kind of ideal graph. I remember the example from the Debian Perl team. They have this graph, which is really cool, but yeah, we are working on this. The goal of this buff is to gather new members who touch the packages with only one maintainer. So it's you who can change it. Yes, and then we have a wiki page with problems where we were working on, and this buff is for discussing, and so we have this GOBI document. If somebody in the room would volunteer to edit this GOBI document, this would be really great. If you have some questions, well, the presentation is in principle at an end. You can ask me questions, I can answer this, but I would like to know what's your interest, why you are sitting here, what science are you representing, what do you want to do in Debian Science. So I would rather like to hand around the mic and you introduce yourself and say, I'm from somewhere, I'm doing this science, how can I contribute, or something like this. Let's start. You have the mic. And go on.
Any volunteers? Or should I do it myself?
It's not about volunteers. Everybody in the room should introduce.
I was asking for someone else to start. So, Jung is presenting for volunteers.
I will start out. My name is John Mad Dog Hall, and I am actually here for the first time about this. So I have no packages that I'm really that interested in, but I'm familiar with a distribution called Poseidon Linux, which was done here in Brazil, which was also a scientific engineering style, and seems to have been released less and less over the years. So perhaps this could be something that would help to augment the stuff that's in Poseidon Linux.
Yeah, it is a separate distribution, right?
Yes.
Yeah, well, I can add something to this, because my observation in the field of biology, there are, over the time, I've observed about 10 distributions with the goal to support biologists. They took one distribution, throw away some stuff, put in addition some biology stuff, did some nice work, mostly 2 or 3 purple, and stopped after 3, 4, sometimes 10 years. Because it's so much work to continue with the distribution that these few people will not manage. And this is the basic idea why I created DebianMed and why we are running the other blends. The idea is not create a new distribution, but stay in the distribution and make the distribution, in this case Debian, the perfect distribution for this science. So the blend is making the distribution of choice for biologists, astronomers, scientists in general. This is our goal, and if you know some people who are running this kind of distribution or formerly were running distribution, please redirect them to us. Ask them what is missing in Debian, what they can contribute and add. We have this case in, that is called BioLinux. It is derived from Ubuntu, but it doesn't matter. And they realized all the people who are driving this distribution went away, found a different job, and now they recommend Debian and the meta package we created. And this is something I observe and in several places, and you can do the shortcut and do it right in Debian. Next one.
Hi, I'm Alfonso, and I'm totally unfamiliar with Debian science. Mm-hmm. And I hope to learn what you guys are doing and, mm-hmm. and you know, take it from there. Yeah.
Are you a scientist?
I am not.
Not, okay.
Hi, my name is Felipe. I'm from University of São Paulo. I'm a biologist, and cool. I didn't know about this project, this Debian science.
Yeah. So you should know about DebianMed because we are friends. We are not separate. We share packages,
yeah, we
right?
Didn't know.
But if you are a biologist and don't know DebianMed, you can blame me that I didn't told you before. So we should talk afterwards.
Yeah, sure. I was searching more about it. Right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, yeah. That's cool. You want more people in Brazil?
I apologize for people on my back. My name is Ranieri Silva. I work before at the Software Sustainability Institute in the UK. And it's very interesting to see the efforts you have Debian science. One thing that I struggled in the past was some packages for R in Python that sometimes you need to use and it's not yet inside Debian because there are so many packages yeah. that's part of like they are in the Python scientific stack these days that is my machine was just getting 2 different packages and sometimes it was conflicting before because you need a specific version that's not the one that is the current one in Debian. And I would love to discuss this with you and other people later.
So do you think you could take over the Debian packaging of something that is missing, what you need? Or do you need some teaching how to package? Or?
Yeah, I started reading some of the documentation, but I never finished. But I just want to discuss more about this problem of yeah. when you encounter some package for that we end up not having some dependence and so on. Mm.
Because people have a problem to say, well, Debian is kind of a hidden society because reading documentation, the shitty documentation is hard. And so my way to solve this problem is in the DebianMed team, if there's a newcomer, I say, if you have a program which is interesting for you, for your work, I teach you how to package inside the DebianMed team, and you can ask any. There are no stupid questions, but people think they are stupid, and they can any question open on the mailing list, and I guide you kindly into the team, where to upload, where the commits are, what's the team policy, and I can do so also for Debian Science in exceptions. I need to restrict myself to something, right? But if you want to know how to package and you have a specific package and are you really honest about it, I would also volunteer to mentor you into the Debian Science team. And then after you have done one package successfully, you can run alone. So you will manage this.
Thank you.
I am Eduardo. I live here in Brazil, in Curitiba. I just came here to watch your, because I'm just working on a project. I'm using the project Boink from Berkeley.
Boink, For getting extraterrestrial life or something like this. So spread things over building a supercomputer on users' hardware, right? This is Boink.
I'm on a project called Rosette at Home.
Rosette at Home, sure.
And I'm here to see how can Debian Science could help me in a software side instead using Windows or Microsoft. To have more performance on my hardware.
That's not actually Debian Science topic. We have packaged Boink, so you can apt-get install Boink. If I'm not really I know we at least we had it, and then you install Debian, you install Boink, and you run it. So if it's faster than on your Windows machine, I don't know what. Yeah, okay, that's a different topic than Debian Science. Mm-hmm. I guess it is, but
okay. Hello. My name is Ralf Trein. I'm from France, and I'm interested in Logix. So I've created a small plant in part of this plants, which is on Logix tools. Logix tools means SEO improvers, proof assistance, tools that you can use for program verification, for instance, static analysis, things of that nature, set solvers, and so on. And
take the mic.
Okay.
Eat it.
Okay. So anyway, so that's what I have to say at the moment. After that, I have a question for you, but maybe we can first finish the presentation.
Yeah, we finish it, and so even the people in the behind rows, I told you, you cannot hide there. Yeah?
Hello, my name is Douglas. I'm from Curitiba, and I am not yet a Debian contributor, and I don't know data science, and here with my first touch with data science, and I think that's it. I was searching a little to know what are the features and how can I contribute. But
the contribution is if you have some software you are using yourself and which is not packaged, build a package and all the world will profit from your work. This is a usual contribution for Debian, and the Debian Science team will help you if it's with a scientific background. This is in short what I can.
Hi, my name is Kate. I don't know anything about Debian Science. I'm curious about the subject, so I come here.
Yeah, but what's your background? Are you a student?
Yes, I'm a student here, information system.
Yeah.
I know about just a little about Linux, but now Debian.
And what topic are you studying?
Here?
Yeah.
I don't know. System of information.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
I'm two but my name is Caio.
This was a very short introduction. Okay. Maybe Ralf, you had a question. Then the next
I would like to introduce you.
You have the mic, you are stronger.
So, my name is Leonel. I'm coming from Cuba for the first time to any DevCon. And
welcome on the DevConf. It's the first Cuban I see on the DevConf.
Thank you. I'm representing a friend who is studying, or who is a researcher trying to graduate in a PhD in natural language processing
we have created a Python library in Cuba for calculating distances between fragments or segments of text.
That's cool.
And I'm here to learn how to go forward, how to create the package, how to add this Python library to the science section, and of course, give this knowledge back to my friend in order to collaborate.
So you want to learn for your in behalf of your friend and then teach your friend, and you both know it.
Yeah, that's it. I already take the workshop from Edilberto on how to package.
Okay.
So I think I can do it right now, but I'm going to learn a little bit more about this section of the repository and, of course, try to be better.
What we can also do, what I've done in the past, packaging workshop. I did packaging workshops the way the audience raises a hand and have, I want to package A and the other package B, and then we pick one and we package in this workshop your package. This is more helpful than explaining how to package, but because we have all the pitfalls of the packages will be included in this session. We can, if there are any people interested, you can register a packaging workshop and do this. This is my offer for you. Yeah, but we talk about the questions here and then we come back to this.
Thanks.
Okay, so first a comment. So there's one thing which obviously distinguishes the Debian Science team from other teams, which is that in other teams you often have other teams are often built around one common technology, like one programming language or one particular framework of applications, like Python, Perl, Haskell, OCaml, or a framework like Tech or things of that nature. And obviously this is not the case with Debian Science. And when you showed the slide with the high number of packages which only have one uploader, I thought that in these other teams, what makes that many, that different people contribute to some packages is that there is some common infrastructure, some dependencies, some libraries which are used by other packages, which are also part of the team. Like for instance, in the OCaml team, we have libraries which are used by other packages, which use OCaml, which use these OCaml libraries. And my question finally is, do you know how many of the packages in the Debian Science team have dependencies which are also maintained by the Debian Science team? Or is it the case that the packages that are in the Debian Science team are all leaf packages?
Well, in general, I want to say you are right, but it's not specific for Debian Science. Also, Debian Games team has lots of packages. So we have the user-centric blends, which have user applications, which has random programming languages. So I have probably packaged stuff in way more than 10 languages, which I all not speak. And which is sometimes easy. I had the RBOF. I can package R packages, basically one new package in 5 minutes, because everything is automatic. And the 5 minutes is from, do you tell me a name and I upload the package, if there are no strange copyright things, right? The normal R packages, I did two, this morning I did two, for some reasons. They are uploaded, so. The difference, or the question was, how many leaf packages related to packages which are more basic infrastructure? The answer is, in the Debian Med team, or also in the Debian Science team, but I know it may for sure for the Debian Med team, which is in principle the same, we include Python modules, other libraries, if they are somehow from the field of biology. You have, for instance, there is a library BioPython, right? It's a Python module. The Python team could take it over, and we can take it over. But because the actual persons, which is currently me, I would love if others would be doing it as well, is more related to the DebianMed team. It's in the DebianMed team. So you have always the option, put it to the language team, put it to the blend team. And you can, maybe you can flip a coin to decide. There is no real way to decide where in the Git, where in the maintenance. And in some cases, for instance, in BioRuby, the Ruby team said, well, we would prefer if it's in our team. It's in their team. That's why we have invented the task pages, or the tasks. There we can pick from every team. The tasks are so-called, if you want to install, for instance, say, astronomy. Well, astronomy is a bad example, but because I have, in Debian Science, we have mathematics. So you have a lot of maintainers who are doing mathematics stuff, partly also in Python, partly in Java. And the task assembles everything in one meta package. So the user has a view, this is the application I want, I don't care who is maintaining it. And the developer has a view, who is my team, who is a different view. So the tasks are the user-oriented view on the Debian package pool, and it's totally irrelevant who is maintaining, and the maintenance is done where we consider it a good idea, which has different factors. But it's not only leaf packages, we have also libraries and so on. Is this the answer to your question? Okay.
Just to be sure that I understand, why should you use a Debian scientific package user develop instead of using like an R or a Python? It's just choosing the team that is going to maintain the package. That's the basically
yes.
The difference.
Well, in principle, it's that way. You have a user who has a request for some software. Mm-hmm. I have colleagues, we need this package. And then it's a request, and I can decide. For instance, R is also a good example. We had R packages in the DebianMed team, in the Debian Science team, and in the DebiChem team for chemistry. It's also a blend. So three teams were maintaining R packages.
The same packages?
No, never the same. No. We're not talking
you
about the same.
You choose one or the other.
Yeah. Only one package is maintained by one team. So and we thought, well, we could have synergies if we create a common R team. And so we moved all the R packages from these three teams into
and
one.
And gathered them all together.
And created a Debian R team, R packaging team, and now all is maintained there because it has quite some synergies. And after this team was founded, we found a way to do this automatically because this had advantages, right? We don't see this really great advantages, for instance, in this Python modules team, because or at least we are not at this stage where we say all the Python modules go to Python team, because for instance, if you are maintainer on the DebianMed team, then you need to subscribe in another team. This subscription might take a week or so, and you have a week delay. And in the DebianMed team, you are just your Salsa login and you can start right now. And this is what people want to do. They want to start right now. It is not that the teams would fight about mm-hmm. the packages. It's just a decision where I'm quicker. And then moving a package is really easy. You move it from Salsa from one team to the other team, exchange the maintainer name and you are done. Mm-hmm. It's a formalism. Very easy, very simple. And if you see advantages, then it will be moved.
Like, for example, if you develop a package for R,
yeah.
and you submit it to an R team,
yeah.
it's going to be available for all R users from all operating systems. But if you give it
I think now something going. The teams inside Debian mm-hmm. have the goal to create a package which is uploaded to the Debian package pool. Right?
Mm-hmm.
For the user is totally irrelevant what team it's, he uses the software, he uses the R package. Debian has derivatives like Ubuntu, Mint, mm-hmm. blah. these distributions are getting this via the derivation from Debian. What the users of Fedora, Red Hat or so are doing, I don't know, I don't care. The R packet is coming from the CRUN mirror. Everybody can drain from there. Everybody can install it right locally, no matter what distribution. But if an R package is maintained by Debian, you can install it system-wide with all dependencies with one click. So if you have a complex dependency tree, and if you install one leaf of this dependency tree, you get everything in one rush, including QA, like we have for the R packages in most cases, auto package test, that means continuous integration. That means if you install the Debian package, then you can be sure that it will run on your Debian system.
So you make life easier for Debian and Debian derivatives users.
Yes. This is Debian. Debian is making the life of its users easier. At least this is our goal.
Okay.
There was another question in the back. No, please, no. Take the mic for the video.
It's a simple question.
I like simple questions.
What's a BOF?
Excuse me?
BOF.
A BOF, a birth of the feather. This is means I don't stand on stage and talk to you, but we talk together. We sit together. That's why I was asking you, please come here. Usually I would love to sit downstairs together with you around the table and talk and not present something. This is a birth of feather. It's a discussion.
Thank you.
No talk. Yeah. There are some newcomers. Can you introduce yourself or are you for the next talk here?
There's no next talk.
Ah, so yeah, for you.
Hi, I'm Nate. I was on a call and then I went into the lightning talk session and it was over, so I came here.
Okay.
That doesn't mean I'm not interested in the subject, but yeah. That is why I came in late.
Are you working in a scientific field?
Sort of. I'm a PhD researcher and I have to do statistical stuff for my work, but it's about typography and not anything boring like physics. So.
So some R packages might be interesting for you.
Yeah.
I am Kobe, and I'm part of the Brazilian translation team. But I'm here because of the science subject. I am a physics teacher for high school students. And I'm interested in knowing a little bit about the Debian science blend.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, by the way, I'm a physicist myself, so it's good to have physics teachers. You might be interested, there is Debian Edu, which is the same what we are doing for science for schools, setting up a school server, and you can set up educational tasks. There's also task physics and mathematics and so.
Yes.
And if you are a teacher and you know some free software which is not yet packaged in Debian, please package it or ask us that we can try to package it.
All right. I believe that Debian Edu is my entrance to this blend thing.
Yeah.
But science is also part of my interest then.
Okay. Yeah, do we have some more questions? Is anybody here who would love to do some workshop about Debian packaging? Not. I have other stuff to do, so it's not that I want to push it on you.
How many hours you spend in average by day packing Debian stuff?
Oh, I can't tell you because it is video recorded and my wife might hear this. So. the honest question is, I don't really know. I'm doing a lot. It sometimes depends. My employer did not employ me to do this packaging, and it's not my work. But in some circumstances, this is helpful if I do the packaging, because we are running Debian in my institute, and if you want to install software, the admins ask me, it's easier to do it with a package, and I do this. And I do it at home, and I do some infrastructure stuff, so yeah, I'm doing a lot. People recently told me I'm the Debian maintainer who has the most packages in the package pool. I was scared by this, because I really don't want to do this. I would love if other people would do this work, but I'm trying to do what's necessary, and if I have the time and the power to do what's necessary, then I just do it. It's a lot.
Thank you.
About the working system on development, how is it? I want to know if everything is made bug fixing and software development in some kind of Git, and how the work is organized in the team.
Well, we switched 2 years ago, 1.5 years ago, to a GitLab instance. It's called salsa.debian.org, and there are all the teams organized. So the Debian Science team had the address salsa.debian.org/science team, and then you find 1,000 packages or so, which are maintained by the Science team, and Debian Med has also the same salsa.debian.org/med/team, and then you find also a lot of packages, and other teams like Debian Edu, and there are all the teams, and also the language teams. For instance, we are talking about the R teams. It is salsa.debian.org, R-PKG-team, and there you find also more than 500 R packages. So this is, and each package has its own Git repository. In most cases, in the normal case, there are exceptions where the team has everything in one Git. But usually one Debian packages maps to one Git repository, and you can even see it. If you have an example package, you can say apt-cache show source, and then a package name, and you see the vcs-git field, which tells you where in Git the package is maintained.
And then for contributing, it's...
Yeah, you create a login on salsa.debian.org, and you ask for subscription to one team, for instance Debian Science, and then you get accepted, and this means you get commit permission to the Science team packages, and then you can start. I would love if the outcome of this buff is if at least one of you would start contributing to this. This is a good goal. You do not need to raise your hand who this will be, but I hope somebody will be.
I'm sure I will.
Yeah, cool. Natural language processing. We have some packages about language processing. So
yeah, my friend and I have been looking around, but
cool.
there is good stuff like NLTK do good, Spacy, Lightbreeze, and some others, but we want to add a new one for a very specific feature, really difficult to complete, especially for my languages, which is Spanish.
Yeah. Sure.
There are not too many tools to complete scientific stuff or scientific task, especially in the NLP in Spanish. So we think we can add this library and contribute in a very formal way for the project.
No habla español.
Ah, sí, a little. Thank you. Questions?
One more. I think the Red Hat OS family, they had a scientific OS, Red Hat.
Yes.
That was ended recently.
Yes. Well, scientific or as I think it's pissed off about his name. Yeah, well, it is not old. Scientific OS is a stripped down CentOS. Stripped down means, as in Debian, we have the philosophy we add scientific programs to Debian, and they strip down CentOS, if I understood correctly. Maybe somebody in the room corrects me, and build a quite solid base, which was it was invented on CERN, on the European.
Accelerator.
Yeah, whatever. And they base all their infrastructure on this, and somehow CentOS is loved by admins, and so they have stripped down the CentOS and gave it labels Scientific Linux, which is in my understanding misleading from the name, but they call it that way. And I have heard rumors that they stopped working on this and provide pure CentOS, but don't ask me. I'm not very secure about this. Do a web search and ask for Scientific Linux.
I was going to ask you if you know if they are migrating to Debian, maybe.
Well, I think definitely not. I suggested this way, way back in the past, and they did not even understand the question. It's something else.
Why do you want the migration?
Why would?
Why do you want the migration?
No, if he knows if they are migrating to where they are migrating, since now they ended the distribution.
I think the idea is Debian is seeking for the last final step for world domination, right? So everybody will migrate to Debian. So sooner or later, also CentOS will migrate. This is the idea of the question.
Since Debian has an entire group dedicated to science stuff, yes. Maybe they
I would
it would be the best
join,
choice yeah. For, yeah. For scientific approach
I would
and
love to if we could join forces. And I think, I would say in the field of biology, we are quite there that if biologists are doing a sensible pick in all distributions, they are using Debian or Ubuntu, because it's quite famous that Ubuntu is easier than Debian, but I don't know why they got this fame, but yes, it's that way. For example, I had a colleague who wanted me to package something, and I packaged his program he wanted to use. Okay, I did the package, and later I asked him, are you using it? He said, no. I said, why not? I'm using Ubuntu. I said, yeah, okay. Why are you using Ubuntu? Because it's easier. I say, well, then you need to rebuild the packet for Ubuntu, and then can you? I don't know how to do it. So, what means easier for you if you are not able to run the program you want to use? If I give you something in your hand, what you can immediately use? Mm-hmm. Well, users are not rational. They decide according to some famous rumors. So if they would be rational, they would install Debian and say apt-get install meet bio, and then they have everything we have for biology, which is a huge set, which is not covered by any other distribution. But they don't do it. Yeah. Recently, there is another thing that is users love Conda. Conda is a competing packaging system. It is neutral about distribution. You can even Conda under Windows, which has one big advantage: you can install different versions in parallel. This is what we can't in Debian. This is a little bit sad. But Conda have other things I observed in my institute. They had a Conda installation, and immediately all Python 2 programs stopped working. Why did the Python 2 programs stop working? Well, Conda, in this installation, had a Python interpreter, which was called userbin Python, which was actually Python 3. And all Python 2 programs in Debian, which are relying that userbin Python is a Python 2 interpreter, failed. So you can shoot in your own foot if you do this, and everything considers some serious knowledge and patience to get everything running. And we try to get it as easy as possible for the users. If they install our meta packages, they should get a complete set of software they need. And in the best case, every single package is continuous integration tested.
You mentioned about Conda, and I have a few friends that are contributing with Conda. And from my experience, sometimes it's really important to be able to install different versions, especially on scientific stuff, because you need a version X, and for another package, you need the version Y. There is any effort for Debian to be able to support different versions with different packages and so on, because basically at the end, just the graph dependence that it starts conflicting when you have
versions. Yeah, well, the thing is the following. For Conda, I say also something, because I realized that biologists want to use Conda, I try to package Conda, right? They want to use it, they should get it. They should get it in a solid form. I'm not really finished this, but in the next Debian stable will be a Conda. Okay? So far, so good. Why can't we do this in Debian? In Debian, you install one package, and it installs the binary to user bin something. If you want to install a different version of this, the package also contains user bin something. And only one can win. You can only install one. You can install an older package, maybe, if you know how to do this. But you can't install two different versions of one package. It's technically not possible, because they install in the same location. And you can build change routes. You change route in somewhere, install this, or you can do virtual machines, or you can install Flatpaks, something like this. But on one Debian install, you can only have one version. This is, technically, we have no better solution.
You can set separate environments, like with Python.
Yeah, there is this environment module thingy. This is changing paths. And so these are all kind of dirty tricks to work around this. But from a Debian point of view, it is not possible.
Okay. Well, sorry. We run out of time. We need to end the discussion, at least from the side of the schedule, so to keep the things running. All of us know Andrea, so we can continue talking around. Let's say thank you to Andrea for his time, and thank you.
Thank you.